Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start 6th chapter of your book Beehive, My Childhood. Here, my refers to APJ Kalam, Abdul Kalam, whose projects in space, defense and nuclear technology guided India into the 21st century. He became our 11th president in 2002, and he is commonly known as Missile Man of India. In his autobiography Wings of Fire, he speaks of his childhood, and this lesson is a part of or an extract of it. Let's begin this lesson. I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras state. The writer is saying that he got birth in a small town namely Rameshwaram, and it is situated in present Chennai, and old name of Chennai was Madras. My father Janusuddin had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. Then he tells us about his father, that his father was not very educated nor very rich, but he was a generous human being. He was a good human being. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother, Ashima. Meaning Ashima, his mother, was his father's best friend, meaning a good helpmate. I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day. Her mother was also very kind, and he said, "It is very difficult for me to recollect how many people my mother was feeding every day. But I am quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together." He said that, but it is quite confirmed that most of the time in my house, outsiders were also eating with us. Second paragraph says, I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks. Undistinguished, not very extraordinary or remarkable. Born to tall and handsome parents. He said, my parents were very handsome, but my looks was very ordinary and my height was also very short. We lived in our ancestor house, which was built in the middle of the 19th century. He said, we were living in our ancestor's house, and that house was very old, and it was so old that it was made on 19th century. It was a fairly large pakka house made of limestone and brick on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram. That old house was situated on the street, old street of Rameshwaram, Mosque Street, and though it was very old, but it was a pakka house. My austral father's father used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. He says that about his forefathers that they were not very much comfortable for luxuries. Whatever was inessential and luxurious, that house, nothing was like that. However, all necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine or clothes. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood, both materially and emotionally. But he says, though money was not there so much, but as far as security is concerned, emotional values were concerned, everything was there in that house for him. The Second World War broke out in 1939 when I was 8 years old. Now he is developing the story of his childhood, that World War broke in 1939, and that year he was of 8 years old. Of reasons I have never been able to understand, a sudden demand for turmeric seeds erupted in the market. Turmeric seed is very common in South Indian lifestyle. So he said, I did not know why it is wrapped in the market, why that seed demand is not there. I used to collect the seeds and sell them to a provision shop on Mosque Street. A day's collection would fetch me the princely sum of one anna. He said he was collecting those seeds and he was selling it in a nearby store of provision store in that street where his house was situated, and he used to get a good amount of one anna. And those time one anna used to be a very good amount. My brother-in-law Jalaluddin would tell me stories about the war, which I would later attempt to trace in the headlines in Dinamani. His brother-in-law used to tell him the stories of war, world war, about Second World War, and later on he was capable to read them in the newspaper also, newspaper headlines. Our area being isolated was completely unaffected by the war. Though the Second World War, any traces were not visible in his small city, small town. But soon India was forced to join the Allied forces and something like a state of emergency was declared. But very soon, as India also could not detach herself for long from that World War II, so when it started, so emergency declared in the country. The first casualty came in the form of the suspension of the train halt at Rameshwaram station. Earlier, Rameshwaram was a very small town. So earlier, Rameshwaram station, railway station was a halt for train. But now, Rameshwaram station, no train was stopped during emergency time. The newspaper now had to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on the Rameshwaram road between Rameshwaram and Dhanuskoti. Now, the newspaper used to be sent through rolling and throwing because train was not stopping. That forced my cousin Samusuddin, who distributed newspaper in Rameshwaram, to look for a helping hand to catch the bundles, and as if naturally I filled the slot. See, now his cousin Samusuddin, who was doing that newspaper work, now he needed one helper because they were throwing the newspaper, so somebody should be there to catch. So he needed, and Abdul Kalam ji did that.